I guess they're here, so we're pretty used to big, huge and bulky, that's what she said, virtual reality headsets. But from CES 2020, we learned that this could be about to end. So let's discover together why headsets are actually shrinking down, how is it even possible, and why just now. So let's get into it, shall we? Okay, so many things happened this year, CES 2020, talking about VR and AR, and there's so much to cover, but I want to focus this video on three particular headsets that kind of redefine what we think about our virtual reality headsets. I guess I'm saying it again. And these are the Huawei glasses, the Pico G3, and the Panasonic VR goggles. All of these headsets or goggles at this point have something in common, that they are very compact and lightweight, something that we're not really used when you talk about our visors that are, as I said at the beginning, usually bulky because they have to house a lot of hardware in there. And this is something that we were able just to dream until now for a VR headset. The Panasonic VR goggles, probably the most intriguing design out there, rock in a resolution of 3840 by 2160, then let's call it 4K, with HDR micro display, so with a very high color gamut, and at the same time, a very, very low screen door effect thanks to the micro display with an FOV though of 70 degrees. That I know that is not much, but we're gonna get to it in a little bit. Then we have the Huawei glasses that probably are my favorite when it comes to design because they really look like a ski mask with an higher FOV of 90 degrees, a resolution of 1600 by 1600 each eye with a pixel per inch of 1058. So crazy eye. And these are actually also supporting the Nolo VR tracking, so there's full 60OF tracking, but we're gonna talk about that later. And then the last one, the Pico G3 prototype. It's still a prototype, this one, but the G3 stands for 3K, that is the resolution of the panels, so very, very high resolution for an amazing clarity, and an FOV, it is around 90 degrees as well. We don't have many more information about this, but all these trees, they actually connect to external source via USB Type-C. So you can connect it with your phone to using the computing power of your Snapdragon 855, for example. That's how they were demoing their CES, and then use them directly like a usual VR headset. So how these companies that are not even the big players in VR right now build such an amazing and future looking design? Well, the fun thing is they didn't use any new technology. They actually went back to an older lenses technology that kind of went in disuse because we needed more FOV and we needed less screen door effect. And there were some stuff that weren't letting us able to use them in a proper way. But yeah, things are about to change again. So where is the secret of all of this? Well, our VR headset, the one that we are used to it, very bulky, use Fresnel lenses. These are plastic lenses. They make a different refraction, that they sit very, very close to your eyes, but they have to sit a little more distant from the panels to actually create a better FOV and to hide a little of that screen door effect that we have with the regular panels that we are right now. We had to use Fresnel lenses because at the beginning we were using the regular pancake lenses that are glass and a little more heavy, and they're the same that we see, for example, on PlayStation VR, or we were seeing on the Gear VR, and we could mod also the HTC Vive to use them. But it's from that mod that we understood where was the problem, why actually manufacturers used the Fresnel lenses instead. Because the pancake lenses have a great thing, that are great in clarity, and that means that they're gonna light every single detail, and every single detail in the good and in the bad. And because before, when we started VR, the display technology was much lower than what we have right now. Like screens on the phone were just starting to have 1440p display, for example. Well, using the pancake lenses meant to highlight the details, of course, of the these panels, the color of these panels, the clarity of these panels, but also the screen door effect, the pixelation that was happening with these panels. An example is the PlayStation VR that has a 1080p display and pancake lenses. And the only way to make it look like usable was actually to put a membrane in front of the display to create a different diffraction to then arrive at the display without screen door effect, and the same thing that then we saw on the Samsung Odyssey Plus, for example, but using Fresnel lenses and higher resolution display. So the quality was a little better there. And another example, as I said, when we use an HTC Vive with the Gear VR mod, there the screen door effect is massive and your eyes kind of have difficulties to actually focus on the game instead of in the grid that there is in front of the game that is made by the space of the pixel themselves. So where is the secret? Well, the pancake lenses can stay very, very close to the display. That's why they highlight the clarity. And that means that you can do more compact design if you don't go too wide with the FOV. Because of course, if you want more FOV, you have to stay more distant from the display itself or create different kind of lenses that have a better refraction of the light rays. Instead, the Fresnel lenses need more space. That's why we have these bulky headsets, and if you want super wide FOV, we have something very, very large, like it are the Pimax headsets, for example. So, as I said, for example, in the Panasonic, they use micro displays, and that means that the space between the pixel is very, very minor and compact. That means that the screen door effect is gonna be much less. The pixel density will be much higher, and we're not gonna have the screen door effect that we are very feared to have on big displays using pancake lenses, for example. But of course, there we have a lower FOV, that is just 70 degrees. Panasonic itself said that they can make the display a little bigger to actually have a bigger FOV, around the 90 degrees. Of course, you will lose some clarity there, but it's all about the balance between what you want for gaming and what you want for just media or media viewing consumption. Huawei Glasses and the Pico G3, instead, they are products that are pretty much already ready for the market, even if the Pico is still a prototype, and they use this 3K resolution or close to that for the Huawei. And again, we have very little space between the display and the lenses, and made them look very, very futuristic. Of course, we have an FOV of 90 degrees, that is not that far anyway from the FOV that was the forced Oculus Rift, for example. But at the same point, having pancake lenses, we have so much more clarity than the one that we had before. And everything is possible because now we can push the resolution much higher in much smaller panels than they were before, having the same results with a technology that was older and meant in disuse. So now everything sounds amazing. We finally have very small and compact VR headsets, but is all roses? No, well, not really, because as I said, the FOV is limited. At the same time, these headsets don't have any hardware inside, like the Oculus Quest or the Oculus Go, for example. They're not standalone headsets. They need still a cable to be connected probably to your phone, for example, with a powerful processor that'd be for sure better, or to a PC, of course. And the other thing is that they don't have hardware, so they didn't have cameras and stuff like that for the tracking. And when the Huawei actually collaborated with the Nolo to have their tracking solution also on their headset, well, the other two, they didn't really disclose anything. So right now there are more media viewing devices like it was the Oculus Go. So should you expect you to use it for gaming, just put your glasses on or your goggles on and be ready like in Ready Player One? Well, probably not yet, but we're getting very close to it right now, and these are the proof that technology is close enough to actually just add maybe some cameras and starting to have the same experience that we have in some bigger VR headset, also in a compact one that you can wear without any problem, don't feel weird wearing it or wearing it for a long time. Right now, this will be great for media viewing. Imagine you are on the plane, you just put your goggles on and you're good to go, and you can keep it for your international flight for 8 or 9 hours without any problems. Because right now, instead, having an Oculus Go or an Oculus Quest or all the others, that like the Lenovo Mirage, for example, that we have right now, they're still kind of heavy and keeping them for a long time, well, it's not the most comfortable thing anyway. But let me know, are you interested in this headset? Do you think this is the future, the way to go, even if we have a little lower FOV? Are you interested to see this stuff just as an Oculus Go substitutes? Even maybe they're gonna be a little more expensive around the 300 or 400. The example is for the Huawei glasses. Or no, it's not for you, or keep going with your bulky headsets and you want just that and get bigger and bigger with bigger FOV. Well, let me know in the comment below. And for now, as always, if you liked the video, like, if you did like the video, dislike, subscribe to the channel for more VR tech, and I see you guys in the next video. Actually, I want to do the Pimax 8K Plus through the lenses video because I totally forgot about it, so I'm sorry about it. And I know that many people are interested because Pimax were very present and CES, so well, we're gonna see it tomorrow or the day after. So stay tuned for that. This time it's gonna happen. And yeah, guys, I feel that was all. So let's keep talking. See you guys next video. Thanks for watching. Ciao.